As we had said, we're all about showcasing our women that are doing awesome things. And this week, we have the phenomenal Sheila Lee. As you can see, we're in the gym, so forgive everything. Look at Sheila.
Everything.
Yeah.
You look amazing.
Thank you so much. She said I look amazing. But I've known Sheila for a long time. She doesn't know this, but I used to look at her body, and I kept saying, body goals, before body goals came out, I kept looking at her body because she has such a clean body and very strong. And Sheila is a fitness director.
I am the complex group fitness manager for Equinox Woodland Hills.
Okay, so Sheila, I said your name is Sheila Lee. Is that your full name or?
Sheila P. Patrice Lee. Okay, fine. I'll give you the full name. Sheila Patrice Lee.
So who is Sheila Lee? I know you, but who are you?
Gosh, I'm many things. One, I'm a group fitness professional. I have an electrical engineering degree. I don't know if you knew that.
Yes. Oh my gosh.
I also have a securities license.
Wow.
And can sell life insurance and long-term health care.
Oh,
so
okay.
There's a lot of different facets to me, but mostly I am a fitness professional.
Okay.
It's something that I have a lot of passion for, and that I've been doing for over 22 years now.
Wow, I didn't know you were an electrical engineer. I have all these accolades with you. That's awesome. So
Thank you. What made
you choose fitness over electrical engineering? After all that
I know, work. All that time. And it took me a little bit longer to get to a degree because I interned with NASA. So I know this
why
is
not
letting out all these secrets about myself. But in my third or fourth year, I told my mom, I was like, sure I want to do this. It seems kind of boring. And she said, you will get that degree and you will not be a professional student and you will get a good job. Because
yes.
Back then they had good jobs.
Yes,
you know,
yes,
the jobs
yes,
where
yes,
you get
yeah.
a pension at the end and all that
yes,
kind of stuff.
Yeah.
So I got my degree and I started working for Procter & Gamble. Worked for them for 12 years.
Wow.
And I was introduced to fitness as part of my journey in college,
okay.
And I was just kind of hooked. And then I went to work for Procter & Gamble,
okay.
And I was working out at a gym, and this lady asked me, she said, hey, would you like to teach? And I said, no, I can't breathe and talk at the same time. And she said, yes, you can. And I started, and then I just started teaching.
Wow.
And then it just grew from there. And then in 2002, mm-hmm. Procter & Gamble started to offer volunteer separation packages, and I said, hey, I'm going to take one. And I did, and I started La Diva Fitness out of that, which, and I did boot camps and
mm-hmm.
personal training and that kind of thing, and I did that for some time. And then in 2008, I was asked to join Equinox as a group fitness instructor, and then 4 years later, I was a GFM, so.
Yay!
Yes, I am.
I was so happy when they made the GFM, Group Fitness
Manager. Yes.
I was so glad. Okay, I'm not going to go into details about the whole thing, but I was yes, And I don't know if you remember, you used to teach at Bally's, right?
I sure did.
And that's
for a really long
you.
Time.
And I remember seeing you when you walked in, when those gyms opened, I'm like, oh yeah. Hopefully she's coming here because, I think you're a phenomenal teacher. I always love taking your classes. And lately I've been taking your spin classes.
Yes.
So what is your favorite class to teach?
You would think it would be cycle because I teach so many.
Oh.
But actually it's cardio kickboxing.
Okay.
And Equinox has this new signature program called The Cut. And
uh-huh.
if you think of it as in a modern update to a Tai Bo.
Okay.
And I love teaching that. I also love teaching cycling. Obviously, I teach more cycle classes than I teach the cut. So that is actually one of my, I guess between the two of those, I don't know if I can choose.
Okay. So the cycling, it's more cardio and the cut?
The cut is super cardio.
It's
45 minutes of nonstop boxing, kickboxing, conditioning.
Oh, I remember taking that for you.
Yes, at Bally. That was my main thing at Bally. So it's cardio, kickboxing. Yes.
Oh, okay. So, so if there's someone, like a woman, who wants to decide which one they should do. You also teach strength class, right?
Yeah, I teach any kind of metabolic, high intensity training.
Okay.
I think you need to do both because
okay.
cycle is very cardio focused.
Okay.
The cut actually incorporates small hand weights,
okay.
so for a little bit of conditioning. Mm-hmm. But as women, and especially as we get older,
mm-hmm.
we need to do weight bearing exercises because it's going to help us improve our bone density because we start
okay.
to lose bone density as we get older. So I would say that you should do both. It's
both.
Not a choice between whether you should do a lot of cardio or whether you should do strength training. It's part of an overall program to improve
weight. Okay. What if you're lazy? Is there a day in your life that you wake up and say, "Yeah, I don't want to do it today"?
Time? No, all the time lately. No, yes.
I thought it's second nature to you.
Yes, no. I am just like all of the rest of the people out there who
uh-huh.
have those days where they're, you know, either tired, exhausted mentally or physically,
yeah.
and, you know, you question, like, how am I going to do this today?
Mm-hmm.
I'm so tired.
Yeah.
But, you know, you find, and we are going to talk about this a little bit, but you find that that passion, your passion and that connection and being wanting to help other people, you know you have to show up.
Right.
Because
right.
if you don't show up, they're not going to show up.
That's
so
true.
It's
That's
part
true.
It's part of the process. And what I'll do is, you know, if I haven't worked out for
mm-hmm.
a couple days or so, I will just say, you know what, you're going to go. Maybe you're just going to be there for 30 minutes. You're not
mm-hmm.
going to do an hour workout.
Mm-hmm.
But there are those days where my body tells me, Sheila, you need to take a break. And
mm-hmm.
I honor that.
Okay.
Because it's important, like we have to have those regeneration days as well as those workout days.
Okay. So have you ever been like, because it happens to me, like there are times I'm like, I really don't want to come out. I know people don't believe that I work out, okay? I do, okay? I'm not in bad.
No, you just walk in, lady. I've never known you to walk out.
So that's what I know. But then those days where I really don't want to come here, but somehow I get here. I think one of them was like last Saturday. I was in your, no, it was Wednesday. I didn't want to do it.
Right.
But that motivation.
Yes.
You kept talking and I'm like, okay. So once I'm here, I'm like, okay, I can try.
Right.
Yeah. So what do you tell people who are not like you, who are not passionate about working out and about doing all this? Is how do you tell them? How do they get up in the morning and come here and
yeah.
do it?
So I think it has to be something that you enjoy, first of all.
Because
it's very, very hard to
That's
get up and go to something that you don't enjoy.
Yes.
So you got to find that thing that works for you. It
okay.
may not be cycling. It may be yoga. It may be bar. It
okay.
may be Pilates.
Mm-hmm.
But or maybe it's walking outside and hiking. Maybe
okay.
it's not even coming into a gym.
Yeah.
I think the most important thing is just to be active.
Okay.
Whether that's in a gym or not in a gym.
Okay. Sounds good. So now let's kind of drift back to you, back to Sheila Lee, because
okay.
we want to know more about you, right?
Hi.
So do you have like a mantra or anything like that that helps you
oh,
grow?
God, I have so many, and you've heard plenty of them.
I have
so
one that is special to you.
Yeah, I think challenge change.
Challenge change.
Yeah.
Wow.
Because there cannot, without adversity, without a challenge,
okay.
you're not going to change your body. So a lot of people tend to stay in their comfort zone.
Right.
I can see it in classes. Like
right.
you get to that point where it starts to become a little bit uncomfortable and you pull back.
Yeah.
But you'll always be at that same place.
Okay.
And it's really about challenging yourself to push through, to hang in there, to go a little bit farther and try. And it's the process of trying, because you never know unless you try.
Yeah, that's amazing. That's, you know, and we're going to come back to the challenge, but I didn't hear about the change before.
I also like to say smile and say yes.
Smile. Especially those people at the back row. So do you have like a favorite song, like a spin song?
Oh my God, no. It's so many.
How about that one, 10 feet high?
Oh, I love that one, yes. 10 feet tall,
yes.
There are so many though. When I choose cycle songs or spin songs, I choose things that have a driving beat, or I choose things that have lyrics that speak to me,
okay.
and it's something, it's part of what I want to share that
okay.
day for
yeah.
people. Because I share a lot about myself in a cycle class, and you know, people always say, oh, you're so motivating and inspiring, but it is really coming from my heart
yes.
and coming from a place of Yeah, and it's not contrived. It's not like I'm making it up. Like, I just go with what I feel that day. And some days I'm feeling like, yes, I am woman, let's roar. And some days it's like, okay, I'm here, we're here.
Yeah.
Let's support each other and let's get through this together.
Yeah. I know it's not contrived and it's not predetermine what you're going to say, because I remember asking you, there was something you said, I don't know what I said, but whatever it was, it was motivating, and it kind of pushed me to go to the next level. So if anybody is watching this today, what do you think, or what do you want them to take away from this, from who Sheila is, from your passion, talk about your passion?
I think one is that I believe that fitness is, you know, and I know this is part of Equinox's phrase. I don't think
we're getting Equinox too much.
But I don't want it to seem like, oh, she got that from Equinox. But I do really think that it's a lifestyle.
Yes.
It's part of, it has to become part of who you are.
Yes.
And it has to be something that you do on a consistent basis.
Mm-hmm.
It's not something that you see as separate, because lifestyle and what you do physical mm-hmm. and having movement in your life mm-hmm. actually dictates the quality of your life.
That's right.
Because if you think about it, most people who are active, and they don't have to be athletes or you don't have to be some like super weightlifting person,
mm-hmm.
but people who are active and physical in their life, they have better quality of life than those that don't.
Right. And being active doesn't necessarily mean that you have to be very thin, right?
No, I don't. I will tell you right now, I come from a long line or a lot of generations of women with big hips and thighs and small waists, and I'm a curvy person. I'm a pretty curvy person. And I can say, like, when I was younger, I struggled with that because society doesn't. It used to. Now, nowadays, it is about having the butt and the thighs. And, you know, it's all about. Black,
it's changing.
You know, it's all about what we see in ourselves.
Yes.
But for a very long time, that wasn't the case. For a very long time,
mm-hmm.
what was considered to be beautiful was super skinny.
Exactly.
You know, skinny, and what I call skinny fat. And I see a lot of that, where people don't have a lot of muscle.
I like that, skinny fat.
They're just skinny fat. And so
I work out.
Right. And I learned to accept the fact that I'm a curvy girl. Yeah. I'm never going to be super skinny. So it's really about me being the best version of myself that I can be.
Well, I think you look amazing, like I said. I used to say body goals, because I'm like, okay, she has hips like me, but she has this thinness.
Yeah.
So it's body goals. So
and I'm always say, we're perfectly imperfect.
Exactly. So you're telling me that you did have some obstacles, right?
I did have obstacles where I didn't think that, you know, I would look at that person and say, oh God, I need to be like that.
Mm-hmm.
But I learned over the years that I'm just who I am, and who I am is good enough.
It's good enough.
It's good enough.
Yes. Own your body. That's what I always say. That's what I always say to myself. I'm like, own your body, whatever it is, own your body.
Yeah, absolutely. Own it. And everything about yourself.
Right.
You know?
Right. So what if I ask you to paint a perfect picture of what you want your life to be?
Oh, God.
Just that perfect life.
My imperfect perfect life?
Yes. I love that.